because you have these bumps under your eyes or around your nose, and you are not sure 100% what it is. Is it syringoma? Is it sebaceous hyperplasia? Or could it be something else? Please do not self-diagnose yourself. So today you will get a good understanding what you may have, but before you do anything, go to a dermatologist or your esthetician so you can get a reassurance to see if you want to do the medical route or the natural route. So let's get started right now. I want to apologize for these lips. I had a reaction with my Invisalign to make my teeth straighter, so now I have swollen lips and crooked. I do have a tutorial on my reaction, so you can go all to see it. I did it last week. So anyways, I want to thank you for being here, and stop staring at my lips, okay? Welcome. If this is your first time, my name is Maria from Aglaia Esthetics. I hope that you enjoy my content and you decide to subscribe. That would make the world to me, and I promise these lips will go down hopefully soon. The difference is that the syringoma, it is affecting the sudoriferous glands, which are the sweat glands. The sebaceous hyperplasia, as the name says, it affects more the sebaceous glands, the oil glands. So there are two different glands that are affected. One is the sweat gland and the other one is the oil gland. And they do look a little bit different. So today I will have several pictures so you will be able to say, yes, I have this, or no, I have that. So quickly, I would like to go over the syringoma, and here is a picture. So you can see that there is clusters, and they usually happen wherever you have sweat glands. So it could happen underneath your eyes, on your neck, in your groin area, under the arms, so anywhere that you have sweat. Now, there is different things that you can do, and if you, before I say anything, please do not self-diagnose yourself before you start doing anything. I would advise you to go to a dermatologist or esthetician. Please keep it that very, very firm in your mind. So there's different things that a dermatologist can do, such as electrodesiccation. So they use a little probe to dehydrate the area. They might give you Accutane or cortisone, cryotherapy, so they freeze dry your area. Microdermabrasion might smooth out a little bit. Some individuals like to use glycolic acids, but it might come back. All these are really quick things to do the surface, and they do not work that well. But if you do that in conjunction with something natural, with natural procedure, you might see good results. Apple cider vinegar, you can use aloe, you can use, there is lemon, there's so many other things that you can use, but my favorite one is apple cider vinegar. But please do look at that tutorial on specifically on syringoma. The sebaceous hyperplasia, it is not something that you need to worry. It's more of a cosmetic one, and you cannot really cover it up with makeup either. And so if you're having these bumps, you might be emotionally upset, so you want to get things corrected. Now, if they're getting a certain size, they can come up to like a 3 millimeters in size, so it's quite large. You might need to do something more drastic and go to a dermatologist. Usually happens to individuals that are more mature, like after 40, and that they've been in the sun a lot. So it is like a little bit of correlation to that. It could also be genetic. So there we go. There's a picture right here. Hopefully you can see that. And there is also a correlation to individuals that had organ transplant. So we are not sure if it is because of the medication that they're taking. And this is a larger one. So what it looks like, there's actually quite a few here, but the larger one, you can see, it looks like it's circular. It's a little bit lighter than the skin. and it has a little indentation. And so some of the things that I want you to be aware and not to scare you, looks like, if you see this one, now you can tell the different. You look at this, okay, and then you see this. It seems like very similar. Can you see that? Now this is sebaceous hyperplasia. This is skin cancer. So if you have a chronic sun exposure, you can either get skin cancer or sebaceous hyperplasia. If you have sebaceous hyperplasia, it's a lot easier to deal with that. First thing that a doctor can do, there's several things, just very similar to the syringoma. They can do electrodesiccation, and with electrodesiccation, basically they dry up that area. You'll get a little scab and then the scab drops off, but it doesn't mean that it's not gonna come back, okay? Or the cryotherapy, they freeze dry it, and but again, it is on the surface. And as you look at some of my pictures that I had previously on the syringoma, and please look at it, when we look at the sudorephrus or the sebaceous, they're quite deep into the skin, and a lot of these treatments are more on the surface, so these things might come back. Some estheticians will say that the microneedling will help. It will not. Microneedling helps on to stimulate the fibroblast, and I do have a tutorial. The fibroblast that will strengthen your skin, it will produce more collagen, so that is good for that, but not for syringoma and not for sebaceous hyperplasia. Another thing that a lot of estheticians will do that have the training is the plasma pen. Okay, so what's happening there is that the esthetician that is trained, she will burn the area, and of course it will form a scab. So that's the plasma pen. And so it's basically the little needle will go, it has like a little zapping thing, and it will zap the area. Would I want to have an esthetician to do that for me? It all depends how trained she is, how knowledgeable she is. So you really have to trust that that esthetician knows what she's doing. And again, the plasma pen is just very similar to electrodesiccation. It will just burn the little sebaceous gland. It will come to a scab, and then the scab will drop off. Cannot promise you that that will not come back. Some of the things that they can do is electrodesiccation, and as the word says, it desiccates, it dries up. Skin cauterization, so it's burning. And again, remember that these two, they will leave most likely sometimes a little bit of an indentation, a scar, either hyperpigmentation or hypopigmentation, light and dark. So you have to be very careful. One of the things that I saw result, laser vaporization, that works really well. Some doctors like to use Accutane, but you have to remember that that will dry out your skin. Microdermabrasion, it might smooth out a little bit, but that is very, very temporary. Do not use any harsh products or scrubs. What you can do at home, if they're this small, you can do certain things at home. However, if they're large like this, then you have to have something drastic, and protect your skin first of all. So some of the things that you can do, especially after you've had a treatment, so you can prevent for them to get larger or to get more. So some of the things that I advise is protection. Protect your skin. And a lot of individuals like SPF, do not do it too high, maybe 15 SPF. The higher you go, the more chemicals. The more chemicals, the cause of skin cancer. So there has to be a balance. What I like to use is mineral makeup, and I have a link below. Mineral makeup is a powder that men and women can use. It will give you some evenness Okay, and it will protect because it has an SPF of 25, so that is good. So we know that sebaceous hyperplasia is something to do an overgrowth of the sebaceous glands. So there's extra gunk in there. And so something that will help is salicylic acid or the BHAs. And that will really clean out, and have a link below of the AHAs and BHAs that you can use, that it will clean out the area. So salicylic acid will clean out the gunk. If you need a little bit extra work, you could use a over-the-counter Retin-A, or you can go to the doctor and they will give you retinoids that are a little bit stronger. Now, vitamin A or Retin-A will normalize the production of oils, but it's also dehydrating. So you really have to do a little bit of a self-balancing. The retinols and the Retin-A would be something if you have really large or larger sebaceous hyperplasia. What I like to use is the niacinamide, and I have a link below, because that will control the production of oil. So you already understand that this is about the sebaceous gland. So if you're using some BHAs and alternate with niacinamide, you will start to see good results. If you're blemish or sebaceous hyperplasia is very large, then you might want to do something a little bit more drastic. Electrologists, they have this a very similar tool, the electrolysis needle, and they can also electrocoagulate the sebaceous hyperplasia, and again a little scab will come to the surface, a scab will come off, and it will give you a smoother look. So I kind of discussed a little bit about syringoma. I went into a little bit more detail about sebaceous hyperplasia, that it could look a little bit like skin cancer. So that is why you need to get diagnosed by a doctor. But there is something else that you need to be aware of, which is called the Molluscom contagiosum. Molluscom contagiosum. Basically, contagiosum means it's very, very contagious. And I have two pictures here. So this one here, actually, if you look at it, it could look like sebaceous hyperplasia. And this one here, wow, who knows what that looks like. It looks like in between skin cancer and whatever. Molluscom contagiosum. So you do have to be a very, very rare. This one here, very contagious, and it is a virus. So you will need to get something from a doctor to combat this. Thank you for hanging out with me, with these large lips and having such a hard time to talk. However, I'm so grateful that you are here with me. We talked about sebaceous hyperplasia, syringoma, skin cancer, molluscum contagiosum, melia, so many things, just for you to be aware. Please remember, do not self-diagnose yourself. If you have something that you're not sure what it is, don't worry if it's only cosmetic. Go and check it out, because we never know what it could be. Remember to subscribe and share this information. We'll talk with you very, very soon.